Hey, AI assistant, I know you like hanging out in the clouds, but can you come down for a second and install Era3D on my local machine?
So today's mission is installing Era, the app that can turn a single image into a colorful 3D model. I left a link in the upper right corner to a guide for running it in the cloud in case anyone wants to give it a test run. Before we start up the local installation, let's make sure we have all the requirements. First off, we need a driver for our GPU. The PC I'm working with has an NVIDIA card, so I'll grab the latest driver. Here's the one I had at the time this video was recorded. Next, I'll install Git to clone the app's repository. I'll download the 64-bit version for Windows and run the installer with default options. The next app I'm getting is Mini Conda, an easy-to-use Conda installer, which will help us keep the Era installation separate from other Python apps on the system. Now it's time to grab Visual Studio 2019. We need it to compile Tiny Cuda NN. If you can't get your hands on that version, you can still install the 2019 build tools for Visual Studio. Just make sure to update environment variables to use the 2019 version of build tools instead of a newer one. This is much easier to achieve by simply downloading Visual Studio 2019. So that's what I'm doing. Grab the installer, let it install Visual Studio, and then add the workload, desktop development with C++. When installing it, I deselected the Windows 10 development kit and replaced it with the Windows 11 SDK, although either should work for what we need. The installation can take a while, so you can use this time to grab a coffee or come up with images you want to use for a test run. With the installation complete, I clicked Modify once more to check I have the required components. The next requirement is the Cuda toolkit. I went with version 11.8 because at the time the video is being recorded, that's the latest one which works well with Visual Studio and my NVIDIA driver. A newer version exists but can't be used for compiling Tiny Cuda. This will probably change in the future, but if you go with 11.8, it's sure to work. If you don't have long paths enabled, you can switch on that option by downloading and running the appropriate registry file. Python library paths tend to be long, and I want to make sure Windows can recognize them. Now we need to add the file cl.exe to the path environment variable. It will be in the Visual Studio installation folder, and we can find it using the file browser's search function. Find the folder where cl.exe is located and copy its path. Then edit system environment variables, find the path variable, add a new value, and paste the folder's location there. I'll quickly check my path values to make sure they're correct. With all the requirements in place, we're ready to create the Conda environment for our Era installation. Start up the Mini Conda prompt and copy the command that creates an environment called Era with Python 3.9. With the environment created, I'll close the prompt and start it in administrator mode to make sure I don't run into permission issues during the next steps. Each time we start up the command prompt, we need to switch to the Era environment using the command Conda activate Era. Now that I'm in the right environment, I'll install the PyTorch libraries. To get the environment ready for compiling Tiny Cuda, we need to set the environment variables using the vcvars script. To locate it, you can use the search function in File Explorer. The file is called vcvars64.bat and is usually located in the Visual Studio installation folder. I'll select Open File Location once it's found to see it in its folder. Now I'll copy the path and cd to that folder in the command prompt. From here, I can run the batch script. It should show an output saying the environment was initialized. With the environment ready, let's check we have Ninja available for compilation. Run the command where Ninja, and it should show the location of a Ninja executable. If you don't have it, you can download Ninja for Windows, extract it to any folder, and add that folder to path. We're ready to install Tiny Cuda with pip. If this step fails, a good place to check for solutions is the Tiny Cuda GitHub page. With Tiny Cuda successfully installed, we can move to the next library, nvdifrast. After that one is installed, I'll switch back to using the Mini Conda prompt as a regular user. Let's change the directory to an appropriate install folder for Era. and clone the repo from GitHub. I created a branch for Windows in my fork, so I'll cd to the Era3D folder and check out the Windows branch. Now I'll grab the required models from Hugging Face with GitLFS. With the models downloaded, I'll manually create a folder for Segment Anything, which should be called SAMPT, and download the model there. Having downloaded all models, I'll make sure the Era environment is active and install the libraries from the requirements.txt file. And that completes the installation. We're ready to launch the web UI by running the command python app.py. Copy the URL by pressing the right mouse button. Don't hit Ctrl+C by accident because that will interrupt the execution. And visit the link in your browser. Give the app an image or use one of the samples, hit generate, and let it work its magic. The outputs will be in a folder called mvres. We'll need this path for the next step. Press Ctrl+C in the command prompt to stop the app and cd to the instant nsrpl folder. Here, we can run launch.py to generate the mesh. When copying the command, make sure to replace the dataset.scene parameter with the subfolder where your outputs were generated. The value should be the part of the path that includes the crop size folder and the scene folder. Finally, you can choose an export directory. I called it output. The mesh generation can take a while depending on your system's graphics card. Once complete, the mesh, a video preview, and a refined version of the mesh will be in the output folder. The refined mesh can be opened with MeshLab, and the original one can be imported into Blender. If you need the refined version in Blender, one way to do it is to export the file in polygon format using MeshLab, and import the .py file to Blender. We can get colors from the color attribute, the same way we did it for the regular mesh in the cloud tutorial video. Well, humans, this completes my task here. For additional info and troubleshooting tips, check the article linked in the description. For me, the installation was smooth, and Era is already generating me new toys on Wanda's local PC.
And it was a lot faster compared to the cloud options. I hope you found this useful. Stay tuned for more AI tutorials, and I'll see you in the next one.